For the first question, we need to get the price based on our product name, and the cell should only allow values that are part of the product list. You can use any of the lookup function to get this answer. For the second question, you have to return the quantity sold for the product 5 in the month March. Please solve it using hlookup. Also, you have to solve the same scenario using index and match also, and it should be dynamic. The quantity should change if we change the month and product name. For hlookup, you can write a static formula, but index match formula should be dynamic. Here we have 100 rows of data with product and employee ID in it, but we do not have the names and price. We need to get these values using our lookup functions, and we need to make sure that our lookups are able to handle new rows. For example, here we have product info for 10 products. If another product is added, our transaction data should populate the name and price correctly and should not display NA. You can use name manager and offset function to do it. Don't solve it by changing our dataset into a table. For the next one, we have to display the tax bracket on the basis of the income of a person. For example, if the person is earning less than or equal to 5,000, they should fall in 0% bracket. If they earn more than 5,000 but less than 10,000, they should fall in the 5% bracket, and so on. What will be the tax bracket for a person who is earning 30,000 bucks? Try solving this with VLOOKUP approximate match, index match, and XLOOKUP as well. For the next one, we need to get the product ID on the basis of product name. See if you can solve this with VLOOKUP. If not, try solving this with index match and XLOOKUP. Also, if the product we are searching for is not found, it should display the text product not found. For the next one, we have multiple matches for some employees. If that is the case, we should display the last value from the range. For example, here John is coming twice, so it should display the second record which has salary as 40. Also, is it possible to return both the matches on the basis of any lookup functions? Let's move on to the next one. Here we want to return the start date and the end date based on the ID, name, and department. For example, here we need to return them on the basis of ID as 5, name as Pam, and department as HR. You can either use index match or XLOOKUP to solve this scenario. For the final one, we have to return the name and salary of the last employee whose name starts with J. For example, we have Jane, John, and James in this list. We have to return the values as James and 50 as output. Please try to solve these questions on your own and post your answers in the comments section. You can verify your answers in the next video as well.